Hello, my name is Fernando Cremer. I'm with Cpine Software, and today I'm going to show you how to get started with Surround SCM in Visual Studio. The first thing we're going to do is install the plugin. So to do this, I'm going to run the client installer for Surround SCM, and I'm going to choose to only install the client. The remaining options are optional for you. On the next window, we're going to only select to install the Visual Studio integration package. On the next window, we're going to leave the default installation directory, and we're going to proceed with installation. Once the installation finishes, we're going to enable the plugin in Visual Studio. So I have open Visual Studio, including my solution, and from the Tools menu, I'm going to select Options, and from there under Source Control Plugin Selection, I'm going to choose a Surround SCM Integration Provider. We're basically telling Visual Studio that for this solution, we're going to use Surround SCM as our source control provider. Notice that there are also user options available to you. So to get started using the plugin, we need to put this solution in Surround SCM. So to do that, right-click on the solution and select Add Solution to Surround SCM. Once you log into Surround SCM, you'll be able to choose the branch and folder where to place your files. Here I'm going to create a new one. And as you can see, the name, the working directory, all the options are already set up for me. It's done automatically. So all I have to do is just click OK. On this window, I will also just click OK, and Surround will proceed and add the files. As you can see now, all the files under my solution have been placed under source control. The lock icon signifies that all the files are currently checked in. And if I right-click on a file, you'll see all the available Surround SCM actions. And now I'm ready to start using Visual Studio along with Surround SCM. If you have any other questions on Surround SCM or any of our other products, please visit our website at www.cpine.com and the Cpine view at blogs.cpine.com. Thank you.